First up, the Constellation Final. This year's Constellation Final features Slate of Crystals from Thundery, Ontario. And from right here, Saskatoon, the Bishop James Bethany Saints. All at peace, the starting lineups. First, over the hill, Crystals. Number 11, Chip Burdowski. Number 21, Alex Sinkin. Golden Sunbeam is first. number 20, Dallas Renault. His first.
Thank you. just drawing this in 6 minutes here in the second quarter. Kevin Purple. Nice finish. 33-6. Someone's got to stop the game. Okay. Pull up. Three.
Several appearances at
Rick Glenn. closer to being out.
Players from Saskatoon's Legions compete in this 3-minute competition. Right now,
Thank you. for the BJ and the Saints. Number 10, Nolan Brunell, he had 15 points.
Chris Pan, we're back here in the second half of our third place game with the Thunder Bay Hellcats Colts versus the South Dakota Bishop. The game was drawn to ball for Chris Pan with 42-15. You see, Coach John Kuke has put the fire underneath his team's collective butt here and trying to get them back in the game. Bay staying in the 1v1 zone. Steve Colladino picked up the foul for Lewis Green. That helps out Colt a little bit on their possession. Adam Sequin is now with 10, the high score for the Colts. Looks like he wants to take some leadership out there. There is a little fire left for the Colts here. Number 23, Kip Irwin steals the ball. Sequin's couldn't quite keep his roll going. Once again, Colladino called for the kind of violation. 1-2. Saints using up a lot of his bench. Guys who maybe aren't used to playing much together. Almost a steal by Colladino. A little bit ragtag. Foul.
Saints number 13, Sean Glasson, his first personal foul, his second in this third
goes up. Oh! And the Brick Dunk champion with the exclamation mark. That's got a quiet crowd back into the game. Big win. Nice backdoor move. Momentum. He tries to match up a little better with the benches in. Oh. Break could be converted by the Colts. Saints move the ball out on the perimeter. Foul on the inside. Cody Bryant. foul.
Belmont Colts, number 21, Alex Sinkins, his third personal foul.
I'm being joined here in the booth by my colleague, Scott Moore. He's on. We are live across the world. Well, the score speaks for itself. Second half a little better with the benches and a little more exciting. And Paul Dino provided a little bit of mustard here for the crowd to get it warmed up for the close game.
Sometimes yesterday, the NFL ignited the crowd yesterday, so I'm coming at 2 minutes.
Yeah, I still think the best bet was the 360 we had in the first round, though. I would have saved that for the end, but I guess if you win, it doesn't really matter when you save it. Actually, I guess I wouldn't have saved it for anything, so I can't do that. Yeah, those first hoops make you pull up your ego, don't they? Well, I was talking to their coach, and I guess a lot of the divisions in Ontario, they don't have a shot clock yet. And no shot clock, so they play a much lower tempo of the game. So I think that combined with four games, I think the Colts are a little bit tired. I think the North Carolina four-corner stall comes into play quite a bit from what I understand. 2 minute possessions. The like. Number 7, Marcus Fisher. One of the first baskets in half for the Saints.
The bigger guys.
You guys run a very disciplined team, and kids know what they expected of them pretty clearly. No, I don't know for sure. You have to check the archives. That's right, with Andy Panic, and that might be absolutely where they were. I don't know if they're in the final, though. Those are pretty good teams from Ross Shepard and Harry Ainley came at that time, so.
I love it when they're a lot of moxie there.
Almost kind of reminds me of Mark Redford last year. Mark McDonald, that's right, came out of the fire truck with the beard, so. I noticed that Nolan Bedell has not seen the photos half. Probably won't play quite honestly for a few times. Chris Carter might want to give him a shot at making the All-Star team, maybe, although his play this tournament, it was the first two games, hasn't been spectacular, right?
Played okay.
A little more from him, they might have been making butt ball going on down there.
Oh, Shaq. Paint there. Didn't quite finish there. Put in a great effort right now.
Yeah, Yeah, yeah.
Most off two teams in the plus out of draw, it's bound to happen.
Should be filling up here, Vancouver.
I think the final will be filled. Maybe some spots, a few spots if you're watching from home and you're wondering whether to stay at home or watch on TV. I'd recommend the live experience.
Well, just for content.
Yeah, well, absolutely, yes.
And if you don't have the blue screen, We're probably painting a picture.
Absolutely.
In your mind. Into the third quarter, 27-point game. Oh! A little excitement. Just over half court, Adam Seguin.
Seguin.
I think that's going to assure him the long distance reward for this game. That's wrapped up.
Yeah, makes it easy for the Jets across the table.
Now, Brad, you played in grit a few times back in the day, and were the all-time honorable mention all-star. Now, going into the third quarter down like this, as you guys were in the New York Elks of 1989, what was the coach's pep talk coming out of the third and the fourth?
Well, it was don't get dunked on, especially in front of the camera. That was one of the main things you want to avoid, is get posterized. I was talking to another Brit alumni, Ian McDonald, and the commemorative edition, he noticed himself that he was getting dunked on by one of the Gauchos. And fortunately for him, the Gauchos in front of his face, but he knew it was him, and so did I. So that was made a few laughs over that.
Well, that's okay. If you get dunked on, if they go to the NBA, it's not too bad.
Yeah, that's true. No, there's not much that I would tell these guys except to enjoy the experience and try and learn some things for when they go back to Thunder Bay and play there.
Maybe they're resting up for the parties tonight. I sure hope the flight doesn't go out too early tomorrow, because normally there's kids at the village like to have a good time on Saturday night.
Yes. Absolutely.
Everybody here.
Oh, and maybe they can learn a thing or two about up-tempo basketball here and change the old stall tactics out in Western Ontario there.
Did they have a three-point line?
Maybe. But the glass backboard I have maybe a couple years away.
Just kidding up there.
I shouldn't want to talk. My high school never got a glass backboard until my grade 11 year, so, and wooden floor not until after I left. So. Well, if you're French, yes.
Of the prairies. So Seguin? Get much
is it Seguin? Would that be correct? The proper pronunciation?
I think it is. Brain and honey operation is trying to get down to the scaffold.
Moss is waiting to happen. Well, some of the holes in the crowd are filling up here. We see some Sheldon Williams fans. Looks like maybe some people came from Regina to the game tonight.
Well, that Sheldon Williams team looks stronger than last year, I think.
Yeah. Maybe not individual players, but I think as a team, they maybe just have gelled a little better, and they really know where they want to be and what they want to do.
still pushing the ball as much as they can.
Oh! And a fan almost got a purple souvenir there.
Oh! Oh, Kelly Bowers.
The brick dental bill.
Yeah, that's right. Oh, he almost hit an ex-Liberal leader, David Carback. Oh. Yeah, in the front row down there. Could have fired him up a little bit.
Yeah, maybe.
Surprised the ball didn't come flying back. He's been known to get a little feisty.
He has, yes. The feistiness runs deep in the Carwacky family.
Ex-Husky basketball player, fabulous five.
Oh, shot clock violation called again. Good Bishop Manning Saints.
That could lead to something here for Dundee. I think. Sure. Shot clock. Although no one's really scored this in the fourth quarter. And 22 gone.
See the Pitt Meadows crew coming in to get dressed for their game coming up in a few short minutes.
They're always a sick ass though. They have all the games.
Yeah.
And this QA goes for 40 years. Knows how to fundraise.
There's some few connections out there. Long
deep
shot. No.
Three. And
no.
A long shot.
Oh.
Number 9. Yeah. This is bad.
Oh. The alley-oop was coming there, but no dice. Oh, number 31. 33. Cody Reed. Took back to a miss. 1-3-1, I think, Cody.
Yeah.
He's trying to keep that ball out of the high post.
Oh. Wow, in the old Russian spot, number 12. Ryan Fraser. Half a shot last ball, I think.
Well, it might be. Being coached by
Steve Ross. He's listening. Scott, you're out of here.
Yeah, we miss a lot.
Nice players, yeah. Parker's still standing up on the bench there. I don't know if he's making reservations for what he wants for something later on. Or maybe
could be.
Get Irwin. Yeah, no. I still can't believe they're just whipping the ball around. For about 5 seconds into the clock, this is desperation time right now. So this should be just run and gun. If that's easy.
Well, I think these guys are playing for experience, and maybe they've already conceded the game.
Steve Caladino, big rebound. As you expect from our 2008 champion.
So Caladino grade 11. Looks like he could maybe, you know, put on a bit of weight training in the off season and a little more experience. He might be a pretty good sport in this opportunity.
He is a high flyer.
So this begs the question, as good as Bishop Manning is in Saskatoon, how could they compete with Sheldon Williams at Hoopla this year?
Oh boy, I think I think the basketball runs in cycles in this province where it just seems that either Saskatoon has a good run of teams, or Regina's left behind. And in the last few years, Regina, on the whole across the board, I believe, has been a much stronger city in basketball. And each AM is the best that we have here in Saskatoon. And I don't know if they can keep up with Sheldon Williams. I don't know Regina's seen very much besides Sheldon Williams, but it's a pretty good league down there. They have a different. They have church leagues that they really start playing competitively in grade 6, 7, and 8.
Yep.
Saskatoon is back right now. So it'll be interesting to see in the next 3 or 4 years how things shape up.
Well, we're talking with Ian Myrtle, the director of the Saskatoon Minor Basketball, about that, about how we can start competing with them. And we had some long conversations about talking about co-ed teams and... the competitive versus the competitive philosophies, those sort of things. So,
well, we like that fun testing. It's just all about playing, all about participation. Maybe down south, it'll be more competitive.
Maybe closer to the state.
Yeah, maybe. That's right.
It should be close to the state.
Oh, are you okay?
Lawyers watching.
Near miss.
getting out for the bleachers is always a fun task for Britt. No one wants to go out their spot, but nature calls, I guess. You have to go out.
I'm surprised that I think we've got the same bleachers, with the exception of a few boards that have changed in the last few years.
Oh! It's amazing how that shellac will preserve that wood, isn't it?
Wow.
No, not really. She's okay. She's okay. Thanks for caring.
Fans here at Bedford are always really concerned about their people they're hosting.
Oh,
yes. The ref sharp eye there, caught the back over.
Nice. Caught that.
Doing a game today with Mike Kaywood, and we're arguing about whether it was actually over and back or back and over. Well, when you have scores like 57-28, a few minutes left, you can ask a question.
Well, I think people are trying to ask
you. You could. However, I think by now everyone is tuned out and is watching, so.
What is that?
It's been worth getting existential on this. Oh, a traveling violation.
Oh, when it rains, it pours right now.
There seems to be quite a plethora of traveling violations this year at Brick. I've noticed a lot of the players on happy feet.
Wow, looks like the Elkgrass called the timeout. Maybe a little trick up their sleeve right now. I'd like to see it.
Yeah, I'm going to put the snap on that runner jump press, maybe.
Good call. That would be a very good call. Whoa, sparkly, spark. Such a... Should it be part of the halftime show?
I don't know. They are wearing the Sheldon Williams colors.
Oh, right, yeah.
So they've got the new trend for the female fans to wear the white t-shirt, tidy whiteys, with the whole school letters on them. Spelling out Sheldon Williams, Holy Cross, Redmond. Nice to see Mike Peach from Bedford Road take the Junior Boys 1-on-1 championship.
Oh, that could go a long way in that young man's career.
It could.
It does seem to be filling up a little bit.
Yeah, the atmosphere is getting a little bit more pumped up. And, my score table to follow people over there if they're sharp in the next couple games, which I don't think will be the same level of defense.
Still playing hard.
Well, number 22, Adam
Seaman. It is. Oh, you don't want to travel all, you know, halfway across Canada to go through the motions. Thunder Bay is a nice place. I've been there. Yeah, my in-laws used to live there, it's a nice place. I don't know for sure. I didn't ever try to do stats on it, but I'd say it's probably a little smaller than Saskatoon. Beautiful country there on Lake Superior.
Right on Lake.
Yep. Absolutely. Gateway to the West. That Churchill.
Whatever.
Oh. So getting ready for that third place game, what do you think Winnipeg's chances are here against Pitt Meadow?
Well, to tell you the truth, I'm kind of worried about the stamina on their legs. Coach made one sub. He's made one sub all weekend, I think. Not that deep. I think Pitt Meadows is a little strong across the board. Fighting over and under here, I'd say Pitt Meadows is 15, 16. But I'm not really confident in this.
Well, I'll take those odds. Winnipeg basketball has always been run and gun, and I bet you those guys are in pretty darn good shape.
Wow, they play the whole game. Missouri kind of doesn't understand.
No.
That's cool. You should get water on the bench.
Well, I remember going there as a high school student playing in the Tech Mock tournament, and we were up pretty big on the team, and we pulled off our press and started pulling the ball back, and we got booed by the crowd. They wanted us to keep going and run the score up against the hometown team, so they expect to go 94 feet the whole game.
Oh, shot clock violation. The Colts there. Surprising. Shots in. If you're
absolutely
play very much, get it while you can. Any comments? What's the email address?
This is britbasketball.net. Of course, that's distributed by the WWW.
And just a lot of familiar faces sitting in the same spot as years went by.
Yes, yeah, we can almost put some brass nameplates on a couple of these benches here. We thought about getting a chair for Kelly Bowers behind the scorer's table, but he'd never use it anyway, so interesting that the Saints cheerleaders have just come out after into the fourth quarter. I'm not sure where they were.
Talking about getting on the bandwagon, just making sure.
Yeah.
Wait to see if the game is in the bag yet. It's a 33-point game right now. But if the front of the day, they're still working hard. And no cheap fouls. They're playing hard and not causing trouble. They probably know they're not matched. No point.
I think the referee is more or less called the listeners for it.
Cardinals.
Turn around, I'm
surprised he's still in there. Off season, second half of Rosen. What dog?
He played behind Riddell, so I don't know if it's a lot of minutes.
Showcase talents for everybody else.
Yes.
We wind down in the 2008 third place in the consolation game.
Yep.
30 seconds left.
Would have been nice to have seen Bedford Road in this. They were a few points away last night from beating Hillcrest, and it would have been nice to have them at the Saturday night. It's been a long time for Bedford since they were that late today.
I'd be interested to see exactly what year. I don't understand this ball. Time out with 21 seconds left. It sucks, I don't know.
It looks like Coach forgot up a play, and I guess every experience is a learning experience, as we say in the education field, a peaceful moment.
Well, you think it's safe to fill in the draw?
I would say you could fill in, or maybe with a pencil, but... And I see over to our right, we have a former Bedford alum, Darren Johnson.
First game.
That's the Buffalo Bills jersey there. Is that not him? That's the big throw.
No, from our air.
Yes, way going way back.
I got you. What's the scorekeeper's name?
Yeah, no, that's Darren Johnson as well. Yeah. We got two of them in the house.
That's how many people are here. The chances that people have the same first and last name. Now, let's see what Coach Clodier has cooking right now. Call that timeout.
Now, this will be worth it only if one of them goes barking underneath the hoop to distract them, and the other guys get a cheap hoop from it.
Goes through the...
Doesn't look like anything special going on here so far.
They hold the ball.
No. All right, we're going to hold the ball for the end of the game.
Look for that good shot.
Maybe they're trying to get someone to score who hasn't scored this year. That could be it. The guy, I don't think number 40 has seen the floor this yet.
Oh. Well, Brad, it has been a pleasure commenting on his game here.
Yes, indeed. Well, if you are still watching, or if you have timed out and have just...